Hello, it's me, and I'm going to answer the question that I posed last time about the similarities. What do all these puzzles here have in common? What is their underlying theme? So we're going to answer that today. So taking a look, starting off with this, well, rather than just have me tell you, let me have Jessica describe it. So what is this?
An Ivy cube, cubic version of a pyramix, a four-sided platonic solid.
Yes, thanks. So this is actually a cubic transformation of a tetrahedron. A tetrahedron is what's known as a platonic solid. So what then is this?
Axis cube. Cubic version of a Rubik's cube. A six-sided platonic solid.
Yes, so this is actually it's a cubic transformation of another cube, but the whole key with this is these both are face-turning platonic solids. And this one?
Rex cube. Cubic version of a face-turning octahedron. A eight-sided platonic solid.
Yes. Thanks, Jessica. This is a cubic version of a face-turning octahedron, another platonic solid. And this one?
Hexamix. Cubic version of a megaminx, a 12-sided platonic solid.
Correct, a dodecahedron, another platonic solid, and finally this handsome thing over here.
Radio cube, cubic version of a Eisenstar, a 20-sided platonic solid.
Correct. Thanks, Jessica. So basically, these are all cubic versions of face-turning platonic solids. So what exactly is a platonic solid, and how does that contribute to perhaps the solve of a puzzle? So a platonic solid is basically a three-dimensional shape, starting off with something like this, where you have the same shapes on all sides that intersect with the vertex, which is the corner over here. So at every corner, you've got these three squares. Here, with the tetrahedron, same thing. If we're going to define this as a corner, three triangles intersect. So a couple of attributes to that. First off, it has to be based on a regular polygon, which is a shape that has equal lengths of each side, and the point at which they intersect can't be greater than 360 degrees. Now, why is that? So let's start off with something like this. So this is a polygon. It's an equilateral triangle. Right, Jessica? Let's move ourselves over here. We're going to explain what a platonic solid is. And thank you for your help. So you see this over here?
Yes.
And what a platonic solid is we have a corner point here, right?
Yes.
It's called a vertex. So we need to fit at least three. Now what's going to make this into a platonic solid? Well, let's take another triangle here and we'll put them together, right? So they're all about this point. Now if I put too many things here and it's 360 degrees, well, what am I going to get? By 360 degrees means it's all around it. So I'm just going to put triangles all around this. Boom. See? So can I make a three-dimensional shape out of this?
You can't.
You can't. Why can't I? Because there's no way to fold it, right? You can't bend the shape.
You can't bend it.
So you can't bend it. You end up with something that doesn't make any sense. You could do something like that, but you don't really have a symmetric kind of a shape with that. So if it's 360 degrees, if it's 360 degrees, you basically have something that's flat. So you have to have at least three. If we start off with three, so if we fold that over, go and fold that over, and what do you get? Now, understand, you can only fold it over because you have a big gap here, right? A big space. So fold it over, and what do you get? Boom! What shape is that?
Tetrahedron.
That's a tetrahedron. Now let's go ahead and close this gap over here. Boom. So this is a tetrahedron, which is four sides, and at the vertex, you have the same shape that encounter at every vertex, right? So this is a platonic solid. So this is basically this. So this is a face-turning platonic solid, and this is a cubic transformation
Wait.
Of that. Yes.
That's not a face turning. That's a...
Well, pretend like this doesn't... I guess we can do a teramynx instead. But a teramynx isn't really a platonic solid because you have a 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. You have a hexagon
this
over here. You have a hexagon over here, and you got a triangle over here. So because you have different shapes, for a platonic solid, it has to be the same shape. You have a different shape. Those aren't called platonic solids. They're called... What is it?
Archimedean solid.
Thanks, Evan. Yeah, it's called the Archimedean solid. So basically with this, if we ignore the tip over here, we'll continue with this. If we ignore the tip over here and move this like that, then basically you're going to say that this is the face. The face means that one of the shapes can turn. I know it looks like maybe you can turn on the corner here, but we're going to call this a face turning. And the IV cube is just a cubic transformation of that. All right, so fair enough. We'll go ahead and put this back. So can I make more things out of a triangle? Well, let's move away from this for a second, and let's look at this. Now, this is a regular polygon, right? What do you see here?
A square.
It's a square, right. Can I make a platonic solid out of this? To make a platonic solid, I have to have at least three squares that are around a point here, right? A vertex. She's gone. She left. Oh, you're getting the square. Okay, thank you. I have to have at least three, and as long as there's a gap, because the total angle isn't 360 degrees, then we're okay. So do you know the angle of a square? Do you know what this angle is?
90 degrees.
Okay, so two, if we put two, go ahead and put another one on that. Well, we have to make it flat first. So if we put two, then this is 90 degrees plus 90 degrees equals?
180.
Right, so 180 degrees. Whoop! Whoa, chaos in this camera. Yeah, so this is, let's actually point this down a little bit. So this is now 180 degrees. Well, we have to have at least three. So go ahead and put a third one somewhere around this point. Boom. So now what's the total angle? We've got 90 and 90, which is 180, plus 90 more, which is?
270.
So we're not 360. If you put another one here, guess what's going to happen? Boom. It's 360, and I can't make a three-dimensional shape out of that. I got to have a gap over there. So go ahead and pull it up and see what kind of a shape you make out of that. Boom. So you see this over here? This is looking like a cube, right? Well, go ahead and do the same thing with three more. Go ahead and make the same one. I think I have to turn it upside down. There you go. And you can fold it over. Boom. So this is the other half of it. Now put them together. Well, put them together and make a three-dimensional shape, right?
No.
Nope.
Oh.
Boom. All right, there you go. So this makes a cube. So this qualifies because we have a vertex and we have three of the same shape that that meets over the vertex. So this is a platonic solid, just like this. This is face turning. This is, of course, the Rubik's Cube, the 3x3. And this is a transformation of that where it's the same kind of a thing. So it's a cubic transformation, but it's like a cube to a cube. All right, so let's get back to the triangles here. Now, we talked about the different angles. You know what angle this is?
60 degrees.
Now, remember how we went like this, and we'll get this back in over here. This, so that's 60 degrees. 60 plus 60 is?
120.
So 120 plus another 60 is?
180,
right, so 180. So that means that I can add another 60 degrees to it, right?
Yes.
Because 180 plus 60 is not going to be, it's not going to be 360. So 180 plus another 60 degrees is?
204.
Nope. 240.
240,
right. So should I be able to make another platonic solid out of this? Could I make a shape out of this? Well, fold it over and see what you get. Because you have a gap. As long as you have a gap, what shape do we have? Oh, so we've got this kind of a thing where you have four that are meeting. Well, if I put this over here, this is basically what you call a pyramid. A pyramid has a square base. That's obviously not a platonic solid, but go ahead and take four of these and make another one of those. So you're basically putting it all around a center point. Excellent. Fold it over. Boom. Now, good, good. Well, you changed the polarity a little bit. So, yeah, I think you have to turn it inside out like this here. Crisp flat there. Now try it. Now we're cooking. Now we're talking. Boom! Aha! So this becomes the Platonic solid that you can make in a, by way of a three-dimensional structure by using 4, because you're not at 360. And this is a?
Octahedron.
So that would be this over here, and this is a face-turning octahedron. And when you slice this down, this face-turning octahedron, you end up actually with a rex cube. Now, why do I make that claim? Why do I say that this rex cube is a cubic transformation of an octahedron? Well, let's take a look at the sides here. If I turn this over here and I turn this over here, what you're seeing is this, this, and this. These three are equivalent to these three center corners here. And these edges over here are equivalent to these edges over here. As we come down to, as we come down further, actually I have to hold it like this. So edge, triangle, edge, triangle. And then as we come down further in, you've got a triangle here and a triangle here, and then you've got a corner here, so this is a corner. So corner, triangle, edge, triangle, corner, triangle. So it's exactly the same. So this movement is exactly the same as this movement. So when you think about it, the rex cube is a cubic transformation of an octahedron. And what I'm going to show is you can solve it really the same way. You can solve this exactly the same way. So I'm going to show an alternative solve of how to solve this exactly the same way that you'd solve that. Okay, now going back to the triangles, maybe there's more we can do, right? Because we have this down like this, right? Actually, we'll fold like this for the sake of the colors. And this whole thing was 240 degrees. Well, couldn't I add another triangle to that? Because 240 plus 60 is
300.
Thank you, Jessica. 300. So it's 300. So I can still have a little gap here. Now, I don't think we can go further than that, but yeah, so 300. So if I were to go ahead and fold that over, see what you get. Get this out of the way. Good. So we have this over here. Now, can I make a solid where every side looks like that? Well, we can. If I were to take the opposite side here. Let's go ahead and do that again over here. Go ahead and, let me do it like this so it's the same. Go ahead and fold this over. Exactly, okay, good. So now, I can't join this to this. It's not quite, I guess I can. That's obviously not a Platonic solid, and the reason is because at this vertex you have 1, 2, 3, 4 joining, and this one you have 5. So that's not the Platonic solid that we seek. Oh, thank you. Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay, awesomeness. In order to join this here, I have to put little triangular pieces all around it. And as long as I don't go above 5 pieces, so I'm going to put 5 around here. This is creating what's called an antiprism. 1, 2, 3, 4. Whoop, 5. Put this like so. And I'm going to keep putting triangles here. A little hard because of the magnets. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Good. And I'm going to put this in. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And now for here, 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. We need to have one more here before it closes off, and one more here. Okay, so this is basically, this is this, but I put in triangles all the way around the equator. So notice I've got this top part, and I put triangles all around the equator here. So now I can take this and go pop, and then I've got this. So by doing that, I get this 20-sided shape, which is?
Icosahedron.
The icosahedron, right. And that is what this puzzle is. 20-sided puzzle, icosahedron, and this is a face turner, this is Eitan Star. I have some other 20-sided puzzles that might look a little bit more pure, so to speak, but this is a cubic transformation of that. So this is a cubic transformation where it seems to turn on the corner, but this turns on the face. But there is one more platonic solid by that criteria, and that is using... So we've used triangles, we've used squares, but what other shapes can be made potentially into platonic solids? As long as the number of shapes around the vertex don't increase, don't go to 360 degrees, then we're okay. Any other shapes you can think of?
Pentagons.
So let's look at this pentagon over here. All right, so the angle of a pentagon here is 108 degrees. And I need to have at least three. So go ahead and get me another pentagon. Nice. Okay, so go ahead and put the pentagons together and figure out which point they're going to be. Boom. Okay, so we're going to say this is the vertex. So this 108 plus 108 is what?
216.
216. So we're still doing good. So now we can put it around another, we want to put it around this point here. Or you can put it around that point. Doesn't matter. Boom. Okay. So you can see there's a little gap here, right? I can't fit anything more, right? So I can only do three, and I've got three. And we know because we have this gap, we can make this into a platonic solid, right? So what's the total amount? We've got 108 times three is what?
324.
324. Very good. So what kind of a shape do we have with that? Well, go ahead and pull it over. You might want to take that up because you're going to magnify everything. Okay, go ahead. Try it again. I'll take this one. So go ahead and pull that over and see what kind of a shape you get. Now, remember, you got to put it into three dimensions like you're doing, kind of collapse it together like you were doing before. You got this gap that it can, there you go. Boom. And, okay, very good. So basically you have this shape over here. Now, can I put it together to create a whole solid?
Yes.
Can I make a solid? Yes. All right, so let's go ahead and do that. Go ahead and do it again. Well, here. I'll pull this up here. And we're going to make... Go ahead and put another one over. Yeah, we'll just make another one. Boom. Splat. Okay. Now, obviously, we can't just hook this to here. We have to make sure that it fills in all the gaps. So we'll fill in the gap over here like this. Whoa! And what I'll do is we'll just keep filling this in. So this will come out across here. This will come to here. And now I think maybe one or a few more to tie it over. Fold it up. Perfect. And now we're gonna slide this into here, and boom! We get this handsome thing. And what do we call that?
Dodecahedron.
Yes, a dodecahedron, which has 12 sides. So this is another platonic solid. Here's a vertex. You have one, two, three that surround three equal shapes. The same shapes are in the vertex here. We can't go any further with that, but that would be this. This is a dodecahedron, the megaminx. It's a face-turning dodecahedron. And the cubic transformation of that would be this guy over here, which is also a face-turning dodecahedron. Okay, so with that said, whoa, these actually all represent cubic transformations of face-turning platonic solids. And that is the answer to the question, and that is what a platonic solid actually is. Yep. Okay, so there you have it. That is the answer, cubic transformations of face-turning platonic solids, the five platonic solids. Now, Jessica, here's a question that I have for you. Are there more platonic solids? We've seen that we can't do more platonic solids with triangles because if this is 60 degrees, if you have more Platonic cells, if you have more than 5 Platonic cells, you have 6, that's going to be, well, 360 degrees or greater. So we can't do anything more than that. We can't do more with squares, and we can't do more with pentagons. What about a hexagon? Can we do that? No? Well, let's see. Let's see. If I were to do a hexagon, let's say I were to draw it. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. I'm a horrible artist. Let me try that again. Can you draw a hexagon?
Yes.
Can you?
Yes.
All right, let me see you do it. 6 sides. Oh, you have totally destroyed. Oh, no, that's a 5 side.
I'm just kidding.
Oh, you were trying to cheat.
No, I know. Wait, how many sides?
6 sides.
Oh, yes.
6 equal sides. Can you do it? Quite sure you can do it better than I can do it. Nice. Nice.
No.
Well, let's see. Maybe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Oh, yeah. Well, maybe 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. I think that's a 7.
7.
Okay. Let's try this again. Point this down. Okay. 6 sides. 5, 6. Okay.
Yeah.
I think we can do a little bit better, but.
Yeah, let me try.
Well,
no,
okay.
Yeah, no, yeah.
Let's try this again. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. All right. Absolutely terrible, but it'll do. Okay, so what is the angle of, because we have to have at least 3, so what is the angle of a hexagon? What is the angle of a hexagon? So that's going to be 120 degrees. So if I need at least 3 to make a 3-dimensional shape, what did I say, 170? Oh no, 100.
I don't know.
3 times 120 is 360. So therefore you cannot make, because all the other shapes are going to have a wider angle. So if I do this here, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, like this. So if I do another one here, if I do it all about this angle here, and I know you probably can't see this, just like that. So basically, if you notice, this is all going to be flat. So this is 360 degrees, so you cannot make a Platonic solid out of a hexahedron. Cannot do it. So that's why there's only 5 Platonic solids. There's only
like this.
Right. There's only 5 Platonic solids because those are the only shapes, and those are the only number of those shapes that can actually give you a 3-dimensional shape that provides for those criteria. Anything more than that, like a hexahedron, will give you 360 degrees if you try to do 3. If you do more triangles than what I've shown, then beyond the icosahedron, that's going to be more than 360 degrees. So, there is only 5 Platonic solids for that reason. Okay, and go! Take 2! Alright. Very good. No, band-aids. Sprains and splints. Let's go.
Whoa, Jessica.
Alright, you got it. Good job, Jessica. Here, hold this for me, will you?